Hi, my name is Dave from GL.iNet. In this video, we're going to go over some of the most common problems when configuring your third-party VPN services on your GL.iNet router. You can check out our previous video on how to configure your VPN services on your GL.iNet router by clicking here. As mentioned, we're going to solve some of the most common problems when configuring your OpenVPN files on your GL.iNet router.
First, the zip file is too big. Second, the configuration file is invalid. Third, the username and password are not correct. Fourth, conflict with other VPN services. Let's look at the first problem. The zip file is too big.
You can put some OVPN files into a zip file and upload them to your router. You need to make sure that your zip file is not too big. Some small routers have very limited storage space. For example, our hot-selling Mango router only has about 16 megabytes of storage space. This means that you can only upload a very limited amount of data.
You can check your available free space on your drive by clicking Applications Plugin. If your zip file is too big, a pop-up will display failed, not enough space.
Let's use NordVPN in this example to solve this problem. If you download your zip file from NordVPN, the file size will be about 20 megabytes. This is too large for some mini routers, so please do not upload your whole zip file to your mini router.
The correct way is to select some servers and make a smaller zip file. For example, if you want to use VPN in Japan, you can select OVPN files for Japan only, and then drag them out and create a new zip file for them.
You will upload the configuration file successfully.
The second common problem is the configuration file is invalid. You may see a message saying failed, invalid file, when you add a new OpenVPN configuration.
We accept compressed file types including zip files, TAR files, and GZ files. For single file types, we accept config files, text files, and OVPN files. If you upload other file types, the router will reject them. Let's use IVC VPN in this example to solve this problem.
IVC VPN provides you with a RAW file. When you upload to the router, it will fail. What you need to do is extract the configuration file first, then create a new zip file. Now you can upload it again.
You will upload the configuration file successfully.
The third problem you may encounter is the username and password are not correct when you connect to your VPN service.
After you click the Connect button, the admin panel will show you the log file of the OVPN connection.
If you get a message saying authorization fail, the most likely reason is you have put in the wrong username and password.
Here is how to solve this problem.
When you encounter this authorization fail problem, double check you have input the correct username and password. For some VPN service providers, such as NordVPN, you need to input your NordVPN account username and password directly.
In case of other VPN services, like ExpressVPN, you will need to use a different username and password. This usually is listed under OpenVPN connection.
Here, ExpressVPN provides you with a dedicated username and password specifically for OpenVPN connection. This is the one you need to type into your router.
So do not use the wrong username and password. This may differ from each VPN service, so please double check with your VPN service provider.
The final problem is conflict with other VPN services when connecting to the OpenVPN server. When you click Connect, the admin panel will display to you a warning saying conflict, other VPN services must be stopped first. When this happens, you must check if you have other active VPN services, including OpenVPN Server, WireGuard Client, and WireGuard Server.
You cannot enable multiple VPN client connections or enable VPN client and server at the same time.
This is because the router may not know how you want to route your data.
In this case, you have to disable the VPN server and reconnect the client.
If you do not encounter any problems, you will connect the OpenVPN server successfully. If you are still experiencing problems, please contact us via our forum or via our customer support email. The links are in the description down below. Please like and subscribe if you found this video helpful, and please leave us a comment down below of any videos you'd like us to do in the future. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.